whole breastfeeding week with you all. I have been very passionate about babies getting the right thing, and it is the birthright of every baby to breastfeed. But unfortunately, we see that that is not happening practically because of whatever exercising reasons, the babies go on top feeding. Here, I'm going to help you show how to breastfeed the baby and when and where we are going to do it. Yeah, so here I have baby of Leslie along with me, who was delivered in a hospital over here. This baby has just taken mother's feet and come down, right? So even though you have a C-section or you have a normal delivery, it doesn't matter. You can just breastfeed. So the recommendation by WHO is that you need to feed your baby within the first 1 hour of birth. All the babies, when they are born, they are extremely active, alert, and they are looking around all over, okay, that they have come to a new place. So baby has its own instincts to use the five senses, and when they use the five senses, okay, they naturally latch. Okay, that is why the recommendation is that in the labor room, whenever the mother is delivering, the baby has to be picked up and put the baby onto the breast. So the baby kind of follows the areola, which has become land. The baby smells the chemicals of the colostrum, and the baby goes and latches on. Now, if the baby has learned to latch at that particular point, you don't need to teach the baby anything else. The baby just follows the breast, and the baby just sucks up whenever you put. A lot of mothers ask me this question, doctor. Doctor, I have had C-section and I'm not able to breastfeed. What do I do? Okay, well, either by normal or by C-section or by some kind of instrumentation does have some sort of pain. It's a rebirth for a mother. Now that pain is obviously going to hamper her position of sitting now. So I'm going to show you a position in which a woman on sitting on the bed also can nicely breastfeed, right? So just give me a moment. I will just show it to you. So the most important thing is wherever you are on the bed, sit with a good back support. So when a woman is sitting with a good back support, okay, she knows that her back is supported, okay, her tummy is also supported and her legs are straight. You can take two pillows, okay, and keep the pillows on the side. Now when we use pillows, the baby normally comes from the side, okay, and hold the head of the baby and the baby comes to you. So the baby is nowhere coming in the way of your C-section stitches and your body is absolutely comfortable. So the principle of feeding is that the baby comes to you and you don't go down to the baby. This is where most of the mothers end up doing. That they do like this. No. Bring the baby to you. So keep the baby on the pillow and let the baby come to you. So the head of the baby is very elevated as compared to the body and the baby comes closer to you. And that is how the babies can latch very easily. And your hand is holding the baby's head. So your baby is in complete control of you. For C-section mothers, or if you have a baby, this is one of the best positions. This is like a football position. It's a modified football position where you can breastfeed as much as the baby wants. See, my other hand is free, my legs are comfortable, I'm sitting in the most comfortable position. This is how you all mothers can also do in your own environment of home or the hospital. Figure out the best position where the baby's head is elevated, the baby comes closer to you and you don't go down to the baby. So this is the most comfortable position what all mothers can experience. Another comfortable position is modified cradle. So in modified cradle position, what we do is we keep a pillow and we turn the baby and hold the baby with the opposite hand. So suppose if I'm feeding with my left breast, my right hand holds the baby. The baby comes closer to me and I will sit like this with the back support. Even this can be done, but honestly, in this again, it comes on the stitches. So if you have C-section in the first 3 or 4 days, you can't do it. The most traditional way of feeding is a cradle position. So this is the cradle position in which, like a chula, let me use a chula. So you hold the baby, so this is the head of the baby, okay? And the body is supported by the hand. But the disadvantage of this position is that the head of the baby wobbles. So when the head wobbles, it is not possible that, you know, you are in complete control. Because even the baby is still learning to feed, the baby might go sleep. You might not know what the baby is doing. Another thing in this position is when you do this, the nose of the baby can come in between. So the breast can go onto the baby's nose and we don't want that. So that is why in this position you have to support the breast, okay, if you are doing it, and you can bring the baby. A lot of mothers are comfortable in this position. Again, this is the most traditional position, but I personally feel in C-section it is not possible, but in a normal delivery it is absolutely possible that you can breastfeed in this position. Now if you have twins, okay, if you have two babies, you can do modified football, what I showed you, and you can hold both the babies coming from different sides. So one baby comes like this and the second baby comes like this. And you won't sit like a queen. So if you have a rocking chair or if you have a back supported chair, or you can go behind it, you can sit and you can breastfeed. So holding the baby is not important, only holding the head is important. This is the important message. Try and figure out the position in which the weight of the baby goes on the pillow so your hands don't hurt. Also figure out a position in which the stitches don't hurt. So every woman needs to kind of identify the best position in which they can breastfeed. So if you yourself can't move into any situation or you have some pain, maybe your husband or maybe your mom or any caretaker who's along with you can help you hold the baby and bring the baby to the stomach, well, so that you yourself are not bothered, but the baby gets depressed. The question always what mothers ask me is, doctor, how do I know whether my baby is actually breaking milk or is my baby actually latching it? Now let me tell you, a latch is nothing but a hemodynamic thing which has a mechanical aspect and which has a physical aspect, okay? So many times we see that the baby is just moving its mouth, but how do we know that the baby is drinking? So here I'm going to tell you all mothers the best trick for you to identify, is my baby drinking or is my baby only nibbling? Now what is a latch? Now a baby has an apparatus in the mouth where the baby has tongue, where the baby has palate and the baby has lips. Now how do we drink water from straw? We do that, right? So that we are creating negative suction in our mouth, and only because of that negative suction does the fluid come into our mouth. Same is the principle of breastfeeding. When the baby latches, okay, the baby latches, this is the upper lip of the baby, this is the lower lip, and this is the tongue of the baby. The baby latches on the areola, the baby forms a seal. So the moment the baby forms a seal, it's like negative suction getting created here, just below, behind the tongue, okay, and because of this negative suction, milk gets drawn from the breast and enters into the baby's mouth. Now majority of people think that the baby is drinking and removing milk. Actually the baby is only drawing milk, it is not removing milk. So this is drawing milk which happens because of the negative suction. Now if this seal is not complete because of any chance, okay, and the baby is not able to do this movement. So by this movement what I mean is that this is the palate and this is the tongue. So the tongue and the palate have to approximate, come closer to each other on the areola, because the milk ducts are present on the areola. So on the areola, if the baby does this movement, okay, then through the nipple baby gets milk. So nipple is only a transmission channel, mind you. Nipple is not the main thing. A lot of times mothers feel that, okay, nipple is in the baby's mouth, if the baby is drinking. No. Till the baby forms the seal, till the negative suction gets created, and till this movement starts coming in, babies can't draw milk. So this movement is nothing but the peristaltic movement of the tongue, and that is why the free movement of the tongue is extremely required so that the baby can actually draw milk and then milk enters inside. So what normally babies do is suck, suck, suck. And sometimes babies take a breathing break, so we might just take a break and again do suck, suck, suck. Now, for you to know whether the baby is sucking or no, most importantly what we have to observe is observe the chin of the baby, this portion of the baby. So when the baby is drinking, it goes down, comes up, goes down, comes up. Like how we drink water, we see our mouth getting filled up. We see the lower portion of our chin going down, coming up, going down, coming up. Same way, going down, coming up, going down, coming up, going down, coming up. Then the baby might take a breathing pause, or baby might stop for a minute and again going down, come up, going down, come up. So this graph, how deeper it goes, tells us whether the baby is drinking. So if the baby is only doing this, the baby's chin is not going down so much, it's just moving like this at the same place. The baby is nibbling, baby is not drinking. That means the baby is holding the breast in the mouth, baby is only using it as a pacifier, but there is no milk transfer happening. So for you as a mother to understand if milk transfer is happening, observing this chin movements is extremely important. So this is a complaint which first 5 days majority mothers tell me, doctor, my baby goes to sleep on the breast. But it is normal. So what you need to do is just give the baby 1 or 2 minutes, let the baby breathe, let the baby settle down, try and stimulate the baby, talk to the baby, give the baby a lot of skin to skin contact and bring the baby back to the breast, the baby definitely comes back. Some people try and stimulate the ears, some people try and stimulate the legs, you can just, you know, massage the hands or legs. Any way which you can with love stimulate the baby and wake up the baby, you can bring the baby back to the breast. So there is nothing like a fixed schedule of breastfeeding in the first few days because the baby is also learning. So till the baby is learning, you have to just allow the baby to be there, drink there and get an idea. Now, if the latch is not happening, what is the way out? Okay, so if the latch is not happening, we need to figure out what is going wrong. Your breast and the baby's mouth is like a jigsaw puzzle. They have to snugly fit into each other, right? So if something is going wrong somewhere with some ratio, okay, the latch might not happen. So then probably you need the help of a lactation consultant to assess that is there a problem with your breast or is there a problem with the baby's mouth. So if you feel that your baby is not latching or the baby is not drinking, please go and take a help of a lactation consultant. Also what I have seen practically is that sometimes the babies don't latch on because the babies get used to getting ready milk from a bottle. That is why the initiation is the most important thing, because if you give the first feed what you give to the baby is what the baby learns. That is the blueprint which is getting established. So if you give the breast to the baby in the first 1 hour and you do not give the formula, do not give the bottle, the baby is going to only take that and the baby is only going to like that and the baby is going to demand that. That is why the initiation is the most important thing. So whichever hospital you are, wherever you are, initiation within the first 1 hour is the most important take home message. If it does not happen in the first 1 hour for any reason, at least within the first 4 hours you try, or the first feed which is given to the baby, try and give only your milk. And that is where your baby will learn how to latch on and you will not have any breastfeeding and latch issues. And colostrum is very important for the baby, so see to it that you make your, give that to your baby. Whichever position you breastfeed, whenever you breastfeed, however you breastfeed, the latch is the most important. If you have cough, cold, fever, or pending dental problems, you can continue breastfeeding. Please do not stop breastfeeding. The only precaution is you have to be careful of your alcohol intake, and in case you are smoking, that which you cannot do when you are breastfeeding or you are taking any drugs. So only then you need to have caution about not breastfeeding, otherwise in any particular practical situation you can breastfeed. When you are breastfeeding, eat enough, drink enough and rest enough. Getting good rest is extremely important, because only when you rest, your body is completely regenerated to produce good amount of milk. And most important, be happy as a mother, do not get stressed. Stress does not take you anywhere, so have a happy motherhood. Thank you. Thank you very much, you all lovely mummies, for watching this, and I hope this was an informative video for you. So if you need any help, you can connect with us, you can subscribe to Baby Chakra, and I'll be here to answer your queries and help you out with your breastfeeding questions. Have a happy motherhood, safe motherhood, and give a thumbs up and like the video if you really like it. Thank you so much.